Hello, my name is Alan Tukmachev, and in this video I'm going to be breaking down my track into bits and pieces and showing you every single pattern and every single sound and all the plugins I used to make them sound the way they are now. I'm going to be breaking down the drop in this video, and maybe in other videos we're going to be breaking down the intro and outro and all of those kind of things. But today we have the drop, and let me just show you the preview that I have prepared for you. Alright, so let's get into this. We have a couple of sounds here, not that many. We have, you know, your kick pattern, claps, snares, we have some hi-hats, some more hi-hats, piano, bass, guitar, and a couple of synths. So let's take a look at the first pattern here. We have three kicks layered. I love layering kicks because they sound much better than just a single kick. Of course, sometimes one kick can sound better than like five kicks, but I normally layer my kicks. So we have three kicks here. We have one, two, three. Every single sound sounds differently. So I just cut the out here. And that's about it. Then we have another kick. Cut the in and out a little bit as well, and the third kick as well, cut out a bit. And sometimes I like to use the filter over here, so this is without the filter. This is with the filter. So the filter is really a cool kind of effect to apply on kicks sometimes when you're layering them. So of course there are different volumes, because if they would be on the same volume, it would sound extremely distorted. So let's take a look at the EQ here. We just kind of boosted up the lows here, just a tiny notch, and the highs. Now, what you can do is you can assign the kick to different mixer track and EQ them separately, but in this case I just kind of put them all into one and EQ them in one equalizer. Then we have a snare pattern, I mean a clap pattern. We have a snap and another clap. First clap I did nothing, just left it as it is, just adjusted the volume, made it lower. And the second clap, I adjusted the shift actually here. And that's about it. Now, what does the shift do? The shift actually, the more the shift, the further the clap is going to go. So just take a listen here. You won't able to hear like this, but if I add a kick, for example, as you can see, this clap is completely off. So that is the reason why I use the shift sometimes. Now let's just take a look at the mixer tracks here. Also put them into one mixer track, so I'd have to adjust them separately, but of course you can do that if you want to. But here I just kind of boosted up the highs a little bit and added a little reverb. What I did is I adjusted the wet, put it up a tiny notch, the decay, some L cut, which is high cut actually, low cut, and high damping. Now if we listen without, sounds really, sounds really tiny almost, so I just added a little reverb on there. Now I really like using reverb because it adds a lot of atmosphere, especially into claps. Though I didn't know why I put snare in there, but whatever. We have another snare pattern here. So I have this snare. Just cut out the out a little bit and adjust the shift just like in the previous clap. And we have a second snare here. I've really removed out because it sounds too dubstep-ish almost, so I just kind of removed it till here. Also shifted this here, so it's all in one mixer track, so we don't have to explain everything again. And let's just take a look at the hi-hat here. Now, of course, I had a reverb on here. We adjusted the wet, the K, the low cut, and the damp like usual. And the try as well. The try is this effect. Oh, sorry. Like, you can only hear reverb if you put the try to lowest. Let's just leave that at 90. Add a little delay, a ping pong delay. I set the time to 4 here. Boosted up the volume tiny notch and panned it all the way to the right. So if I played the hi-hat, it pans on both sides. So that is why I adjusted the knob like that. And we have stereo enhancer, which is kind of the same as the delay, only it does not delay, it just pans. So I just put the stereo separation to plus and adjusted this knob to the right. This is the phase offset and the panning to the right, so you can hear how it bounces from one ear to another. Really cool technique. Of course, we have a piano over here. And in this piano, we have a lot of effects. We have an equalizer, boost up the highs, cut away the lows, have a phaser. Now, why would you add a phaser to a piano? When I produce music, I really like to push boundaries and add effects to sounds that usually are not meant to be on. You know what I'm saying? So I added a phaser to a piano, and you can hear the difference. Hold on. Yeah, we have a limiter for sidechain. The way sidechained is I just clicked on the kick, went to the piano, right clicked, and sidechained to this track. And then you come over here, adjust the sidechain. So it would be like this. I put it up, turned up the ratio, and lowered down the threshold. So we have a filter that is just used in the other parts of the track to bring out the piano a little bit more. So in some parts of the track, the piano is like right here, it's filtered. If you listen here, and right here it's not filtered anymore. So yeah, that's why I use the piano filter. So we have a multi-band compressor, of course. What I did here is just turned up the gain. The multi-band compressor is kind of equivalent to the equalizer, just a little fact, and just boosted up the gain here of the high band, boosted up the gain of the mid band and the low band, and I put the gain of the master up as well. So that's a little difference here. Then we have a really huge reverb, turned down the dry notch, boosted up the wets, decay is up. I always adjust the same knobs when it comes to delay, reverb. So I have the decay up, the damp, the low cut, and I sometimes adjust the cross. But those are like the main kind of knobs I adjust in the reverb. And we have a delay, of course. Again, a ping pong delay. The time is set to 4, volume down, and the pan is all the way to the left. Well, not all the way, it's kind of halfway there, but yeah, that's it for the piano. Here we have the same piano. If you're wondering why does it sound so realistic, because I actually recorded this piano on my MIDI keyboard. So I first played the chords on my MIDI and just recorded them into the the piano roll, and adjusted them manually with the mouse, so it's all perfectly. But as you can see, if you look closely, the notes are like shifted a little bit. And the way I did that is I went to the snap to grid and just put it to none. And now I have the freedom of moving the piano the way I like the note. Just put that back to main. And as you can see here, all of the velocities are different. So those are the chords. And then we have guitar here. As you can see, obviously I didn't record this with my MIDI, I just did it in FL Studio, so every single note is perfect. Velocity didn't change anything, so let's just look at the effects a little bit. Again, I added that sidechain that I was talking about previously. We have the reverb, the wet is up, the K is boosted up a little bit. I didn't really adjust the damp that much. The low cut is up, and I think that's about it. Then we have a multiband compressor over here. Again, I use the multiband compressor just for the gain here, so I just boosted up the gains in every single band, just a tiny notch, and boosted up the master gain as well. And then we have the EQ, and this time I lowered down the high band. And the low band. So with that, and with, all right. Now let's go to the fun part, the bass. Actually have a layer of bass. We have two sub basses. This is kind of a pitchy one, and we have a second one which is kind of a sine-ish bass with some distortion on there. Let's check out the mixer track. We have an EQ on here, really decreased those highs, cut off the low a little bit, So if we remove the Q. Yeah, we have distortion on here. Boosted up the threshold and the preamp. That's about it. So without the distortion. And we have a limiter for what? For sidechain, of course. So yeah, that's about it for the bass. And this is the guitar, the really reverbed guitar. Actually, I did record this guitar melody on my MIDI first, and then I applied it to the playlist here. The piano roll, and then just adjusted the notes manually. So just take a look at the effects. We have quite a few on here. Limiter for sidechain. I gotta go into that. We have a delay. I basically use the same delay in every single synth or instrument. So it's at 4, like usual. The volume is kind of at 11 o'clock there, and the pan is all the way to the left. EQ, really had to boost up the highs here, because listen, we're down. Just wanted that present feeling, you know. We have reverb, really big reverb this time. Although the original synth already had reverb, so I just kept it, but I boosted up the reverb a little bit with the Fruity Reverb 2 as well. Have a flangus on here. Again, we're pushing boundaries, guys. I'm adding a flangus on a guitar. So, you know, when it comes down to music, just try different effects, try everything. So put on effects on sounds that you normally would not put on. So a flangus on our guitar. We have a filter that is automated throughout the track a couple of times here. I think it's automated. Let's see. It's automated right here. Right there, you see. So it's quiet here. It's really filtered here. And it's really present here. And then finally we have our two synths here. Just filtered currently. I don't know how to pronounce this, but this is a pizzicato. We have reverb on here. An equalizer, boost up the highs a bit. You know, many equalizers repeat on and on here. I usually do the same thing, just boost up the highs and turn down the lows. These kind of sounds. Limiter for sidechain, flangus, distortion to give that massive feeling, you know, and filter for automation, and some delay on here. Again, same delay. As you can see, everything's repeating. And then we have this sound here. This square lead. And straightforward, just put out the highs. And we have reverb on here. And finally, our key sounds. Is this guitar here? Really crucial in the drop, in the second part of the drop. It really gives that present feeling. So we have a reverb on here, an equalizer, and a limiter. And then the second sound is a little I don't know what that's in called. That's about it for the effects of this track. If you want to kind of want to learn more about sound design, just let me know down in the comments. But thank you for watching. I hope you liked my track that I broke down to you today. So thank you for watching and see you next one, guys. Peace.